And so we will sing the additional weekday program being the Rose Island host Nancy Sarah Barakas. And this is the program that brings you up to date on the key shows and key guest look at the women's weekly headlines here in Egypt. Our main topic of discussion tonight will be the much anticipated two-day visit by Russian President Vladimir Putin to Egypt, which starts off tomorrow. The visit will be President Putin's first to the country in 10 years and follows a meeting held between the Russian leader and President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi in the Black Sea Resort city of Sochi in August of 2014. Both Putin and al-Sisi will discuss ways to advance bilateral relations in addition to regional and international issues of mutual concern. A Russian presidential delegation arrived into the Egyptian capital earlier this week to prepare for President Putin's visit. They held talks with Prime Minister Ibrahim Mahlab, during which they discussed a number of proposed projects to be created in Egypt with Russian help. And one of the questions that I'll be posing to my guests tonight will be how they see the agenda of talks, whether or not they see this as a pivotal relationship build up to between Russia and Egypt, and exactly what they expect the outcome of such a historic visit to be. That's some of the questions that I'll be putting to my guests. But as usual, we also like to bring you another story making headlines here in the country, and this one takes us to Yemen, where the Houthi rebels have taken over power on Friday and said they were dissolving parliament and setting up an interim government. Now, the move has been denounced by rivals as a coup Saturday, so the Houthis say they are open to working with other political factions. Thousands have been protesting against the takeover in cities across the country, and the UN Security Council has warned of unspecified further steps if the group does not immediately return to talks. The Houthis took control of parts of the capital Sana'a in September of last year, forcing the resignation of President Abdelrabi Mansour Hadi in January. And joining us to tell us more about the situation and another analysis is Dr. Maroun Al-Khaili, Professor of Political Science, who joins us from Washington. Thank you very much for your time, sir.
Thank you.
So is it safe to say that what we're witnessing in Yemen today and what we witnessed on Friday is indeed a coup?
It could be a coup, but you know, it involves a deal known for a long time, because the new Hamas, the Houthi group, is applying what you can call freedom attacks. It is not just the pattern of occurrence that you move if you just be able to capture power. No! It has been going on for a long time, it's a process, it's actually very much predictable, and I do not think there is any resistance. But even the armed forces of the Republic of Iran were employed in a way to use violence, and in this case actually initiate a counter-attack to Houthi with the one who moved in to Sana'a, to the capital. It's not a coup, but definitely it is a very, very serious situation. It's less abundant, it is deteriorating, and so far no one is able to do anything about it, including
okay, well let me ask you, so Saturday saw the Houthis say that they are open to working with other political factions. Do you think that the country's other factions would be willing to sit down with the Houthis at this point in time?
This is a good question, because I saw that in the newspaper, and also I tried to create information about Yemen. The answer simply is no. From what I read, that a group or a coalition of Yemen parties has required an invitation to participate in a dialogue with a Houthi group. In addition, it has been a growing trend for decision-making in the power. This is very regrettable. 20 years ago, Yemen was able to achieve a unity between the north and the south. Yes, it was violence, but it was unity. Now, unity of Yemen is being disintegrated, and I do not think I'm going to be able to defend the fight against the position. You have to realize that Yemen is very poor, Yemen is very isolated, other Arab countries are busy with Syria and Iran, so it seems a big, big crossfire, and hopefully some solution will happen to redeem the cause.
Well, ideally, what would that solution be? I mean, I understand that today the UN envoy to Yemen has returned to Sana'a and resumed contacts with major political players to find a solution out of the crisis. Do you think that's going to suffice?
That's an actual optimistic position. and the people that want.
No, the United Nations envoy has returned to Yemen. Do you think that they, that person or the UN as a body could help bring an end to this crisis?
I doubt it. I think they doubt it for all different reasons. Yemen leaders, Yemen groups, Yemeni parties are not willing to cooperate with an international mediation.
Well, sir, ideally though, what would be the situation? What would be the way out of this crisis?
I think it should build some kind of involvement. Egypt should intervene along with Saudi Arabia, along with the other Gulf states. The Arab countries should be joined and peacekeeping their ports. We should hold the conference. The United Nations could participate and could be invited. But I think it could an Arab diplomatic effort, and that should be deemed a crisis.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ravi Mikhail, Professor of Political Science from Washington, speaking to us there. Thank you very much for your time. Ladies and gentlemen, for the evening's first report, let's take a closer look at tomorrow's visit by Russian President Vladimir Putin, and obviously some of the topics that are going anticipated to be on the agenda of talks.
Russian President Vladimir Putin will visit Egypt on the 9th of February for a two-day visit by invitation of his Egyptian counterpart, President Abdel-Fattah el-Sisi, during the much-anticipated visit. The leaders will discuss bilateral relations and exchange views on the current regional situation, especially the situation in Iraq, Syria, and Libya. They will also discuss ways to push forward the peace process between Palestinians and Israelis. This is the first visit for Putin to Egypt since 2005. The visit is closely linked to talks that took place between the two presidents during el-Sisi's visit to Russian resort of Sochi in August 2014. During the meeting, the pair exchanged views about the Middle East situation and engaged in discussions on developments of economic and trade relations and in the sectors of tourism, education, culture, and science. Russian Deputy Prime Minister and his accompanying delegation are already in Cairo to prepare for President Putin's visit. The Russian official held talks with Prime Minister Ibrahim Mahlak to explore ways of cooperation in economy and investment sectors. The two officials also discuss a number of proposed projects to be created in Egypt with Russian help. They include setting up a free trade zone between the two countries, a Russian economic zone, a power generation project, coordinated efforts on oil and gas exploration, and importation of Russian meat. Sergei Vershinin, the Russian Foreign Minister's special envoy, described Putin's planned visit to Egypt in statements to the Middle East news agency MENA earlier this month as historic. A Russian presidential aide also expressed Moscow's willingness to take part in a bid to create a nuclear power station in Egypt, disclosing that a related scientific study has already been conducted. This summer marked the 70th anniversary of diplomatic relations between Cairo and Moscow, and year 71 of the Egyptian-Russian relationship does appear to hold much promise for both sides.
The National Project, fully financed and implemented by the Egyptians.
لأن احنا متأخرين قوي. طب والله العظيم
Dr. Salim Barhan, Food Assistant TV for Melissa. Thank you very much for coming in tonight. Also, joining me is Dr. Hassan al-Shaqal, Chairman of the Egyptian Women Council. Thank you very much for your time tonight. And lastly, Salim, I'm going to start off with the obvious question of yours, is how important is this visit by the Russian President to Egypt?
This is a very important visit by the President Vladimir Putin to Egypt, and this is signals the historic relationship between ex-Soviet Union and Egypt, and later on